Hello, welcome to the session on LRU and optimal page replacement policies. Here LRU stands for least recently used. My name is Dayanand Patil, working as assistant professor in computer science and engineering department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. At the end of this session, students will be able to explain LRU and optimal block replacement policies and solve the problems and calculate hit ratio for these methods. So before coming to LRU, in the previous video lecture, we were discussed the first in first out method. In that method, the block which was replaced first into the cache memory, that was deleted to replace the new block in a main memory. But in this method, this policy selects for replacement of block that was least recently accessed by processor. That is, the blocks which are existed in the cache, among them, the block which was least recently accessed by the processor, that is deleted and replaced the new block. And in this policy, it is assumed that the block which was least recently accessed by the processor is not referenced in the future. Based on that assumption, this policy is implemented to increase the hit ratio. In this LRU implementation, that each block in the cache memory is associated with an counter called as age register, which indicating the block which is least recently accessed by the processor. This is the example. Considering a paging system in which M1 has a capacity of 3 pages, that is M1 refers to the cache memory which size is 3 pages, and that executing application require the 5 distinct pages 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These pages are accessed in different stream. So this is the stream required to execute the application, and the answer is, so this is the status of the cache memory at different stages. Initially, the block 2 needs to be transferred from main memory to the cache memory. So first 2, there is all blocks are empty, so 2 will be placed here. Next 3 need to be accessed, so 3 is not existed in the cache memory and the next block is free, so 3 is placed here. Next 2 need to be accessed, 2 is already existed in the cache, so no need to access the 2, so cache hit occurs. And 3 is marked with a star indicating that the 3 is least recently used. And 1 need to be accessed, so 1 is not existed in the cache and there is an empty block, so 1 is placed here. And next 5 need to be accessed, so 5 first it will check for the 5 is existed or not, no, and it need to be replaced any one of these blocks because the cache memory is full here. Okay. So that 5 is replaced with the least recently used block, that is 3. So now this is the status, and the 2 is marked with a star indicating the least recently used block. And 2 needs to be accessed, so 2 is already existed in the cache, so the cache hit occurs and the 1 is marked as the least recently used. And 4 need to be accessed, the 4 is not existed in the cache, 4 is replaced with the 1. And 5 need to be accessed, so 5 is already existed in the cache, so no need to access, the cache hit occurs and the least recently used is marked with a star. Next, the block 3 needs to be accessed, so 3 is not existed, so it is replaced by 2, and 4 is marked as least recently used. And next 2 needs to be accessed, so 2 is not existed, so it is replaced by 4, and the 5 is marked as the least recently used. And 5 need to be accessed, so 5 is already existed in the cache, so cache hit occurs. And next 2 need to be accessed, so 2 is already existed in the cache hit occurs. So after end of this process, we'll calculate the hit ratio, that is total number of hit occurs, that is 5 divided by total number of access. The hit ratio is 0.416. Next is the optimal replacement policy. So this policy selects for the replacement of block which would not be used for the longest duration of time in the future. Okay, so in this method, it is assumed that, okay, so if we use the block which is, okay, if we delete the block which is not used for longest duration in the future, then that will improve the hit ratio. Based upon that assumption, this is implemented. Now this is time to reflect. So repeat the previous example for optimal replacement policy. Okay, that is previous example is, this one is the previous example. So same example we are considering for the optimal replacement policy here. Okay. So now we are familiar with how to perform that replacement policy, but in the optimal replacement policy, based upon the point mentioned in the optimal replacement policy, we are considering and performing the replacement process. Okay. Now pause the video and perform the replacement method. Answer is, so here, so again for that example, this is the blocks accessed in this stream. Okay, initially that cache memory will be empty. Here we are not indicating any of these blocks with the star because we don't know which block needs to be deleted, because if we need to replace any block, we are observing the future list. Based upon the feature list, we are deleting, so we are not indicating in advance any of the block to be deleted. Okay, so first two need to be accessed, so it is placed in the first block. Next three needs to be accessed, it is placed in the second block. Next two, so two is already existed, so cache hit occurs here. Next one need to be accessed, so it is empty block and one is not existed in the cache. Okay, so one is replaced here. And next the five need to be accessed. So we are observing 2, 3, 1 in the future list. Okay, so that 2, 3, 1, 2 is here, 3 is here, so 1 is not present here. Okay, so 1 is replaced with 5. And next the 2 need to be accessed, 2 is already existed, so that the cache hit occurs here. Okay, so that 2, 3, 5, the cache hit occurs. Next 4 need to be replaced. Okay, the 4 is observed in this cache memory, 4 is not present in this memory. Okay, so that 4 need to be accessed and it should be replaced. So we are observing 2, 3, 5 in the feature list, which is not used in the longer duration, that is deleted. Okay, so 2, 3, 5. So 5 is required here, 3 is required and 2 is required here. Okay, so before 2, 5 and 3 is required. So 2 is replaced. Okay, and 4, that in place of 2, the block 4 is replaced. And next 5 need to be accessed. Okay, so that 5 is already existed in this cache memory. Okay, so 5 is replaced, that no need to access the 5 and the cache hit occurs. And next the block 3 needs to be replaced. Okay, so that 3 is already existed in the cache memory, the cache hit occurs. Next 2 need to be accessed. Okay, so if the 2 need to access, we need to replace any one of these block because the 2 is not existed in the cache memory. Okay, so at this time, so we are observing 4, 3, 5 in the future list. Okay, we'll observe 4, 3, 5. So 5 is required and 4 and 3 is not required. So while replacing 2, we are going to replace instead of any one of these blocks. Okay, so that is 4 is not required. So 4, that 2 is replaced with the first block, that is 4 is not required and 5 is required, so we cannot. And instead of 3 and 4, any one can be used. So first block 4 is used here. And next 5 need to be accessed. So 5 is already existed in the cache. So that is why the 5 is, that cache hit occurs. And next 2 need to be accessed. So 2 is already existed in the cache. Okay, so that cache hit occurs. Okay, so at the end of this process, again we are calculating the hit ratio. Okay, so that is, again the hit ratio equals to that number of hits divided by the total number of axes. Okay, so the hit ratio equal to 6 divided by 12. Here 6 is the number of hits. Okay, so that is total number of hits is 6, and divided by that total number of axes. The total number of axes is 12. Okay, so 6 divided by 12 is 0.5. Okay, so now if we compare the first in first out method and the least recent used method and the optimal replacement policies, we are getting the more hit ratio. Okay, so that is, that hit ratio is increased in this method. Okay, that is 0.5. For the previous method it was less than 0.5. So according to this problem, that we conclude that optimal replacement policies will give that increased hit ratio compared to the previous two methods. So these are the references I have used. Thank you.